Welcome back. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe, add a comment, and smash the like button to support this channel. Thanks. This is lesson 6 of the book Residential Design Using Autodesk Revit 2024. We will open the previous lesson, which is lesson 5, and then do a save as lesson 6, save as project. We don't want to deal with any backup files, only the names of the files that don't end up with .00, you know. Anyway, so I noticed that there was a trim of interior partition. I need to fix that, so I'll do that first. Then I'm gonna check it out, see, make sure everything's working. So that's the first floor plan. I'm gonna switch now to the basement floor plan, and then turn this into a coarse level of detail or medium level of detail, and then go ahead and look at what we have here. So it looks like we have we can see the first floor partitions under the second floor plan. And in the site plan, I'm changing the scale to 1/8 inch, medium level of detail. I'm hiding the model origin, the triangle and the circle, and just making sure that everything is working properly. Again, these are like minor issues, but you know, if you are actually doing this yourself, you need to know about those. Back to the basement electrical plan, changing the scale to 1/4 inch, degree of detail to medium level of detail, first floor electrical plan, second floor electrical plan, hiding the elevation tags, just overall maintenance. Okay, so the 3D view, we will make sure that is set to 1/8 inch, medium level of detail, hidden line, and I may go ahead and go to the graphic display options and look at the show ambient shadows button, and then under lighting, I like to set the sun intensity to 100%, ambient light to 5%, and the shadows to 30%. Once you do that, you start to see the surfaces that are closer to you as lighter in color, and the surfaces that are away from you as darker in color, so that it reads better this way. Right, so I'm going to select all the exterior walls of the building except for the garage, and then I'm going to change those to a specific wall type, which is the one you see on the screen. In shaded mode, you start to see some color. And then I'm going to go to the garage walls, select all instances visible in the view, and then change that to a different wall type as well. Basically you can choose whatever you want, but it must be an exterior wall though, not interior partition. So first I changed them to exterior wood siding on wood stud, but then I went back and changed them to a different type. To kind of more match the house. Okay. So once we have that, we can look at the thickness of the wall, make sure it's close to the original base plan. And save the project. Okay, so a lot of things that are, that can go wrong, what did go wrong, and I kind of kept some of those in the video so that you can see. In the second floor plan, we need to get rid of the underlay. First floor plan, set it to none in the properties, and make sure you don't have that visible because it's confusing, right? Exterior walls will extend past the first floor into the second floor. Then we'll go ahead and use the insert link add command, linking the second floor AutoCAD drawing into the second floor plan. It should line up exactly at the same origin. And then what we have to do here is simply add the interior partitions. We don't need to add exterior walls because we use the same exterior walls as the first floor. I'm going to use the same method, which is using the simple draw tool. Revit is able to snap to the center of the wall, and that's really good, using an interior 4.5 inch partition. Process can move really fast, and here I'm just skipping a few steps so you can see, so you don't get bored. There is a partition sitting on the far right of the floor plan that is not exactly the same size, but we can deal with that. Just want to make sure that things touch each other. You can also use the align command to align it on this, on the interior side of the building. And if there's any wall that's short, we need to stretch it to make sure it blends into the opposing partition. So I'm moving relatively fast here, so this is why you may be thinking, why didn't he just go and clean up the partition on the far right? But I'm just trying to finish this as fast as possible in order to use your time efficiently here. I'm adding an opening and the doors, and the first door that I add should be renumbered to door 201. The subsequent doors will be numbered to 202 and automatically by Revit. So we'll use a single flush 36 by 84 partition or door, and add that. It will be automatically numbered, and also a sliding closet door, 72 inches. The closet on both sides. In this case, you can just eyeball it. It's okay if it doesn't have to be exactly in the center of the room or the closet. After the fact, you can come back and select those big doors and change them with a smaller door for smaller rooms, such as bathrooms or closet spaces. And it's just a matter of find and replace. Okay. I'm not too concerned about the door sizes. That's not really the purpose of the exercise. But if you want to follow the book, you know exactly what needs to be done. Now these doors, 204, 204 and 205, are the wrong type of doors, so I'm going to fix that problem. Go back to single flush. This is what happens when you work fast, you're not paying attention, and then Revit catches you off guard. Okay, so it looks like things are looking good. I'll go ahead and add my windows, just like we did in lesson 5. And we'll make sure that the window sizes are the correct size. So You can just add the window, small window, and then go back and measure the distance and then resize it. Here we go. This is looks up more appropriate. 38 by 42, single hung windows, which is the, you know, the type of window that's used in most of the residential houses in the US. At least in the South, you know, maybe the North is a little bit different. But you know, it's a good placeholder for what you're looking for, which again can be replaced later on by with another type of window if you want. You can tag the windows on placement, or you can tag all after the fact. Just checking to see. Selecting the window, right click, create similar would be a good way to start, and then make a duplicate copy of it, changing it to 30 inches wide is what I'm doing here. After you rename it, you want to make sure the width is correct, 2'6", and then place it. So that's close enough, you know, it's not exact, but it's close enough. And I'm trying to, you know, work as fast as I can in order not to waste time in the video. And then I discovered this needs to be extended in order to trim the wall. Now we switch over to the basement plan. We do the same thing. The first door that we add in the basement plan, of course, after you add the partitions, is door B01. And then after that, all the doors will be subsequently numbered exactly the way we want them, B02, B03. So you would just link in the basement floor plan and then go through the same process as lesson 5 and lesson 6. Next is to add the concrete walls for the exterior of the basement, right? You are using the core face exterior and snapping to the using the pick lines method and snapping to the exterior face of the wall. And it should be exact match because it is a 12-inch concrete wall. Now you want only one click on each side. If it doesn't go all the way to the end, and you use a trim command to trim the corners. You don't want to have multiple walls line up in the same side of the house. So for the garage, you will use a smaller size, which is a 10-inch, or maybe it is an 8-inch. So we'd have to make a new type of wall. So I decided to go back and trim those corners first, and then there are no shadows in the basement because the shadows are by default fall on the first floor level. Okay, so here we go. We have all these exterior walls. They're in the right place in 3D. It may be a good idea to have them, to see them side by side if you need that feedback from two views. Back to the basement floor plan, double click to go back to the basement floor plan, and right, so we do have a 10-inch wall that we are going to make a duplicate copy of, and we'll just call it 8-inch. we'll change the thickness of the wall in the edit structure, and we'll place them the way same way we placed the other walls. Now the wall, these walls are going to end up being on the basement level, which is all the way down at the bottom. You will have to change that. You know, we have to make a decision. Does the basement have, is under the garage, or is it just a crawl space, or what is it? So in this case, we will not have a basement under the garage. You'll have to select the basement walls, use the selection filter to uncheck the anything but the walls, and simply change their elevation to a different level. You want their change their base constraint and top constraint to the proper level. The base constraint is going to be the foundation level, and then the top constraint is going to be the first floor. And as a result, they will move up as indicated in the blue color on the screen. This is an initially, this is the proper way to do it. Later on, when you look at the elevation view, you'll know, start to notice that there's maybe too many levels, so we don't need the bottom footing level. We can delete that. That's the structural. Now, in the book, there's a suggestion that to change the level to level height to allow for a little bit more space for the ceilings, and we're going to do that at some point. So here I'm thinking, what should I do? Should I move it? Should I do it now or later? Right? You will notice also that some of the levels are blue in color. The target thing is are blue. Some of them are black. So blue levels have corresponding floor plan, and black target levels are kind of called orphan. They don't have a corresponding floor plan. So I'm changing the top of footing level to -13.3 right now. Let's see if that will hold. The basement level to -12. Yeah, again, doing a lot of calculations on in my head as we go through this. You know, having a 8 foot or less basement height is pretty low, you know, because you have to have the structural beams above and everything. So I need to give myself a little more space in order to kind of show you how we can do a kind of fancy ceiling in the basement. That's why I'm changing the level height. And that's suggested in the book also. If you just want to see the result of this, you can just fast forward maybe a minute or two to see the end of this exercise. So I decided to create a 1'6" new wall up under the first floor, and then another 1'6" at the bottom of the basement. Okay, so that looks more organized. Let's select all the basement walls and change their base constraint, top constraint. So the top constraint is first floor, and that's exactly how it should be. And then base constraint is top of footing. Okay, so that looks the way it's supposed to look. Eventually, we're going to put some foundations on those. So So base constraint for the garage walls is foundation level, and then top constraint is first floor. Right, from a structural standpoint, there are four types of foundations we can add in Revit. We'll use the bearing footing, and we simply just use the tab key to select all the walls, and then simply click on the mouse. So tab once, click once, will allow us to put these foundations. So it's a pretty simple process and gives you a pretty visually convincing foundation. Of course, we don't size foundations as architects or interior designers. We leave that to the structural engineer. So this is a coordination issue with the engineer, which we're just showing those as a placeholder for the purpose of the exercise in the book. Okay, exterior walls needs to go from the first floor to up to the roof level. And you can see how they just update. Garage walls have to go to from the first floor up to not the second floor. It could be second floor with the top offset. So I'm just going to give them a top offset of 5 feet above the second floor, because the roof of their garage is going to be lower than the rest of the house. Again, you can refer to the book to see what the final look of the house looks like. Okay, so now at some point I will realize that the floor-to-floor height from the first floor to the second floor to the roof level is not exactly the way I want it, so I will have to change that as well. Here's the stairs. There's two stairs, one from the basement level to the first floor, and the second one is from the first floor to the second floor. Of course, the attic access is not through a stairs, but through a ladder or something. I'll use the stair command, run option, to add a stair with a landing. And since we changed the floor-to-floor height to 12 feet from the basement to the first floor, then the stairs will have to have like two landings. I think it will be more appropriate to meet code requirements. You can see the landings in the 3D view as we go through this. We got a warning, but that's kind of a minor issue. It has to do with the railing, but that's... we're not focused on the railing right now, so let's finish the exercise in the book with creating the staircase. I just noticed that I don't have an opening on both sides of the hallway, so I'm going to go ahead and add those openings in there on the basement level. Okay, so looks like there's one more, and this is a small opening, 36 by 84. You can see that in 3D. Okay, so that works pretty well. Okay, so we have the first, now the stairs is a little larger than the one in the book because of the floor-to-floor height has been modified to 12 feet. The purpose of this is to give us a little bit more space. Okay, so here we go. Now you can see how we changed that. We changed the roof level to 24 feet and the second floor to 12 feet. Oh, 24. Okay, I think I'd... you're seeing different iterations of this, you know. And sometimes I change my mind and do So the walls that are constrained with the roof level, they will continue to grow or to follow the roof level. Okay, so it looks like this is working in the elevation view. Now I'm going to create the floor, the staircase, and from the first floor to the second floor. Now, of course, you want to make sure that you have the proper landing and the start location, end location, in order not to end up with a big mess. So you want to check your work in section view and in 3D view to make sure that you have the proper thing. So as you can see, that's the initial design of the staircase, but it may not be the final design, so you may have to delete it and start all over again. It looks like we have a conflict. Sometimes you don't know, really appreciate the how things can interfere with each other until you look at the 3D view. I'm gonna give it a spin and see what. I'm using the shift right click here in order to spin the model around, and there's obviously an issue, so I need to fix that. So I decided to change the basement stairs. Again, there's a lot of things here I'm keeping in the video in order for you to see that design is an iterative process, and it may not necessarily you get to the correct solution from the first time. You may have to do it a couple of times in order to get it exactly the way you want. So we have the first run, we have the second run, and we have the third run, and you want to keep going until you get to zero risers remaining. And you need to just keep checking, make sure the risers line up with each other, make sure that the landings are correct. So here I realize that I need to do this again, so. Okay, so you get a warning, and this warning means that you're missing one riser, so I need to go back and fix it. Okay, so it looks like I deleted that part of the staircase. I'm gonna add another piece in order to make sure I have the proper amount of risers in there. Okay, so it looks like it's working. We have the proper head height. But the partitions, interior partitions, may not be exact, so I need to modify those. So design, of course, is a complex exercise, and it you have to look at it. Ideally, you want to look at this in section view, interior elevation view, 3D view, and then in plan view, make sure everything is working according to the plan. I'm aligning the wall with the stairs, making sure that you have something against it. And okay. Things are not perfect, but we're heading in the right direction right now. Okay, so interior partitions are in the right location, but the top of these partitions may not be aligned with the stairs exactly, so we'd have to deal with that in the section view. Okay, so checking, making sure everything works. I may have missed an opening. The kitchen. As we get to the end of lesson 6, we want to remove all the AutoCAD DWG files from the manage links command, making sure that they are not there before we save our project, and then, you know, make sure we fix some of the tags, the door tags. I'm using the arrow keys on the keyboard to nudge them over. I'm going to use the tag all command again to tag all my windows, making sure that nothing is missing. So don't worry, it will not make a duplicate, tag for you. It will only be tagged once. Do that in all the floor plans. And, we have the garage tags should be moved as well. And the basement openings. Make sure you save on a regular basis. And we're going to check the visibility in the view range. I'm going to change the view range in the basement floor to show unlimited bottom and unlimited depth, and that will show me the foundations. Once the foundations are visible, then I'm going to work on the exterior edge of the foundation, and I'm going to use the modify menu line work tool and then use a line style called hidden, and that will overwrite the display of the view, so the view shows the foundation is a solid line while the line work tool will show that as hidden. This is a view specific command. Okay, we're not replacing those lines, we are changing the visibility of those lines from solid line to hidden line using the line work tool. The interior edge of the foundation in the basement plan does not need to be changed because it will be hidden by the slab inside the floor slab. And that's the end of lesson 6. I will see you on lesson 7.
If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe, add a comment, and smash the like button to support this channel. Thanks.